Catherine Green, if you have been poor, please excuse me just talking and saying the same thing. But Mushroom Green as a chain shop has been... Thank you very much. This is volunteer chain maker, third link of life so far.
Thank you so much.
No worries. Mushroom Green as a chain shop has looked kind of like this since probably about the 1850s and was demolished mainly to the point of like down to the almost the bottom of the windowsills. By the 1970s, and then the industrial archaeologist group rebuilt it with Ron Moss and a bunch of volunteers. And now we run it as a volunteer thing. Please come and have a look and sort of experience what chain making's like and what has like been like in the area for hundreds of years. Nats is a women's chain maker and working on half an inch thick bar.
Yeah. Made this morning. afternoon, sorry.
If you have any questions about the women's chain making or just chain making at all, Nat can answer.
Or the chain
making stripe. Particularly. I'm making 5/8 of an inch thick bar, which is sort of probably the smallest thickness that men would make. And the difference being that we would have our bar cut to length and we would work off the bar. Which I won't say everything you would say.
No, you just you've got a measuring tool and a cutting tool here, so you just have to do that extra step.
And that women have to go collect all their own metal and work off the bar and got paid a fraction of the wage, and we're expected to do all the housework and looking after the children and everything else as well.
Yep.
But it's great now, the 21st century, because it's all better in these little things. Which is but so I'll do the expression now.
I'm
start with a pair of straight cones, like that, which will grab the bar in that kind of specific way. And poking for the fire there. And a really good chain maker, what they will do is they'll be able to overlap the processes. So one, I'm just making one at a time, but a good chain maker make three or four. Do you want me to add to your link now? Yeah? Okay, great. So, do you want to do the hitty bit? Okay. When it comes to that bit, I will let you know if you can come in. I'm going to put an apron on for this. So, what happens is the metal will be heated by the coke, and in here you've got a fan which blows through the tweer and heats the coke up in a very specific sort of area, so that you've got a concentrated heat of about 1200 degrees, and that means that you can really sort of like fix where you're heating on the metal to an area of about 3 inch square, the size of a tennis ball about is your heat centre. Rather than a big like a coal fire or charcoal or something, it's a much bigger, wider spread heat. So now that's got that temperature, I can turn it over. Put it back in the other side. So now the heat's going to pass along to the other side of the bar, allowing me to get a sort of unified temperature all the way through, so that when I bend it, you can just bend in one place rather than another. So think about metal. Is that you'll only bend in its softest point, which is the hottest point, or its thinnest point. As important as the fire is the water. The water does all the cooling. So the clever thing about all this system is you've got water going into the tweer, which is like, oh yeah, like a sort of metal cone, the air goes through. Cools the metal down and then it cools back up because the boiling water rises. I just love that system. It's like a zero moving parts, unmechanical way of getting things to work. Looks like a